The next day at college, one of our friends, John Tobin, calmly let us know that he had dodged the cordon the night before because he wanted to get to his flat near Wigmore Street, which would have taken him hours if he had followed the diversion. Basically, he had quietly ambled along the length of Oxford Street just minutes before the bombs went off. A very lucky escape. I was hugely fortunate to get a full grant for my whole time at Trinity, but usually around halfway through term, things started to get a little tight financially. A couple of the older players at college told me about an interesting and potentially entertaining way of adding to the term coffers. Around the corner on Marylebone Lane was the London College of Dance and Drama, and pianists were always needed for ballet classes and the like, so I turned up and offered my services. I ended up playing quite frequently and thoroughly enjoyed myself. Extemporization and understanding how the classes worked came to me quite easily. Of course, it helped that one of the teachers, Jill Henderson, took me under her wing and really was very clear in her musical instructions before any given exercise, and I learnt very quickly how a ballet class was structured and what types of music were needed for the various disciplines within. I also played music that was contemporary and that people knew. For example, pliés, which is usually one of the first sections of class, sits really well when accompanied by Cavatina from The Deer Hunter, which was very popular at the time. It was a good challenge for me to find something that would fit really well with the movement. It was also really satisfying seeing how the girls in class responded to the motivation of having music they knew. There was also one wonderful coincidence about Jill, which I only found out much later. Her sister is Mary Pelham, so she knew all about Trianon, and just maybe that explained the simpatico that we felt when I played for her classes.